Welcome to the third session of French Music in America, the 2021 President's Day Conference of the New York City chapter of the American Guild of Organists being held virtually. In previous videos from this conference, we heard a panel discussion on the influence of the French tradition on contemporary organ life, and a lecture recital on French classical organ repertoire by Dr. Andrew Henderson. It is now my pleasure to introduce the internationally renowned concert organist Christopher Houlihan, performing on the largest instrument in Manhattan, the Aeolian Skinner of St. Bartholomew's Church on Park Avenue, where Paolo Bourdignon is our host. For more information about the NYC AGO's mission and events, how to become a member, and how to support our efforts, please visit our webpage via the link below. And do follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube page for more content. My name is James Wetzel, and it has been my pleasure to be your host as the sub-dean and the chair of the program committee. On behalf of all of the board, thank you again for joining us.
Good evening. My name is Christopher Houlihan, and it's a pleasure to join you for the annual President's Day Conference of the New York City chapter of the American Guild of Organists. The theme of this year's conference is French organ music in America. And I am seated here at the console, the organ of St. Bartholomew's Church on Park Avenue in New York City. This is in fact the largest pipe organ in all of New York City and a quintessential example of American classic organ building, a style which developed throughout the 20th century with the goal of performing all of the organ's repertoire equally well. And this is no exception with French Romantic organ music. I think you will hear in this evening's program a wide example of the sounds and colors of this amazing Aeolian Skinner organ, from the lush strings of the celestial division to the beautiful solo stops, English horns, French horns, oboes, trumpets, to the more modern and neoclassical sounds showcased especially in Marcel Dupré's two sketches. I hope that you'll enjoy this evening's program full of French organ music played in America.
Thank you.
Next on the program, I'd like to share pieces by Claude Debussy and Louis Vierne. First, an arrangement of the slow movement from Debussy's string quartet, arranged by Alexandre Guillemont, who was a French composer and virtuoso organist who toured extensively throughout North America, wowing audiences with his technique. This arrangement of the string quartet takes on a new life on this organ, exploring all the different orchestral sounds, French horns, flutes, clarinets, and oboes, taking on new scale and life on this scale organ. And after that, I'll play the Water Nymphs of Louis Vierne, Naiad. This is from a set of 24 fantasy pieces with all sorts of mythological titles like Clair de Lune or Gargoyles. And this is a very fun, playful scherzo. And I'll follow that with the finale from Louis Vierne's First Organ Symphony. This is perhaps Vierne's most famous organ work, which is a real pleasure to play on this extraordinary organ here at St. Bartholomew's Church. This year, we're celebrating Vierne's 150th birthday. Vierne was, of course, the famous organist of Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. And he, too, went on a tour of North America, playing, in fact, also here in New York City and around the country, raising money to restore the organ of Notre Dame Cathedral. It's a pleasure to be here for the President's Day Conference of the New York City chapter of the American Guild of Organists. Here we go with Claude Debussy and Louis Vierne.